Namaskaram, Bhagavad Gita, 2nd chapter, Sloka 51. Lord Krishna taught Arjuna what is Atmajnanam and what is Swadharma, what is intellect, how to do karma. And in these three slokas, 51, 52, 53, he explains the one who follows all these teachings attain moksha. So how does he attain? In first sloka, Lord Krishna says, the jnanis, the wise, endowed with equanimity of intellect, abandon attachment to the fruits of action. By working in such consciousness, they attain the state beyond all sufferings. So they don't suffer anything. They don't even realize what is sorrow, what is happiness, because they are going beyond that. They don't expect the fruits of action. They do their duty but do not expect any results from that, and they look at everything equally, whether it is sorrow or joy or pain or pleasure, victory or defeat. As far as they are concerned, everything is the same. So this is how the jnanis, the wise people, follow the teachings of Lord Krishna. So Krishna explains how they are elevating themselves. We are all bound to seek happiness. So what happens when we go in search of happiness? If we don't get it, we become disappointed. And when we expect any result from the action, from the karma we do, if the result is not in favor of us, we don't feel happy. If we get misery, then that means if the result is not unfavorable for us, then the misery gets aggravated. So the result is we are not able to concentrate on anything else. So we go only in the material path. We seek more and more material happiness, because once we lose it, our tendency is to chase after it and do anything to get it. So we are not able to control our mind, and we do more and more bad karma when we are in search of material happiness. So if we take people, we some of us suffer from bodily related issues, some of us suffer from mind related issues, some of us suffer from wealth related issues, and all this are concerned with the material. So if we don't get that, we feel that people with material, that is, we look at other people, they are happy, how come I am not happy? Why I am getting, I am doing the same karma, but how come my result is not favorable for me? Why am I getting unfavorable results? So this thought goes on in our mind. So naturally what happens, we never feel happy at all. So Krishna says, such people, because they are in search of happiness, and they go for making materials. But what happens when they are not able to reach that happiness? They take new turns. That is, they take U-turn towards the spiritual path. Only then they realize, okay, I've tried so much in material path, but I'm not getting happiness. So what is to be done to get happiness? Then they move towards spiritual path. Even if we move towards spiritual path, are we successful in that? When are we successful? If our intellect has become steadfast with spiritual knowledge, and we understand God is supreme enjoyer. We find many people having money, but they don't find happy there they say, no, I'm not happy. And we don't even make out that they are happy because they are in search of more and more material. So they want to attain only more material, so they are losing their happiness. They are not happy with what they have and they are not enjoying that. So that is a problem they are facing. So even if you go in spiritual path, if your intellect has become steadfast with spiritual, that is, you have to fix your intellect in spiritual knowledge. Only then you understand God is the only supreme enjoyer of the things in the world. He's the supreme enjoyer of the world. So when you have that knowledge, we accept anything as the gift of God, the prasadam of God. So you develop that contentment there. So when you have that kind of attitude, naturally you will not do more and more of karma which brings you bad effects, that is bad karma and good karma. So when we do karma, naturally it's a mixture of bad and good. So when we are towards material, we tend to do more of bad karma. So what happens? We are not free from those karmic reactions. So Krishna says, you should be contented. You should be happy with what you got. And don't ever feel both happiness and sorrow. So jnanis do not feel. And they do not expect results of their actions. And he continues his teaching in the second, that is next sloka, the 52nd sloka. Intellect, when you cross that delusion, so when your intellect crosses delusion, you will develop vairagya. You will show your indifference to all what you have been hearing and what you are hearing and all the objects which create delusion in your mind. So you will decide, no, I don't want that. So you will stick on to that. You will not have wavering mind. So that is what steadfast in spiritual knowledge. So when you have that intellect, naturally you are not allowed, that intellect does not allow you to have delusion in your mind. And in Vedas we find there are guidelines to do the activities to get material wealth and to go to Swarga. When intellect is with spiritual knowledge, my intellect will not long for the material at all. So what will I do? I will lose interest in such rituals. And the sages, we can find, they go beyond all these rituals because they have gone to the stage of realizing God, the Brahman. So they need not do all these rituals. So the sages, the jnanis, they go beyond the rituals and they know all this, what all available around us, all give only temporary pleasures. And don't expect any result from the karma we do. So this, we get this kind of knowledge. So God teaches us how to cross delusion. So what is to be done with your intellect? In the next sloka, 53. If you remain steadfast in your divine consciousness, you will attain the perfect yoga. So yoga is a discipline. It's a sadhanas we practice. And when you practice that, when you become a perfect yogi, you will dedicate to only sadhanas. So if there is a question in our mind, can we do away with the rituals. Is it okay? Will it not cause sins? God says, when you do rituals and you expect results from that, it is not good. If you are expecting results from, returns from the rituals and do it, it is not good. And it is better leaving the rituals and following the sadhanas. Fix yourself in sadhanas. So in the sloka, in 53rd sloka, we come across the word samadha vachala. That is sam, S-A-M, that is equilibrium, sama, the intellect. So one who is steadfast in higher consciousness, we say higher consciousness is soul, atma. And higher consciousness means say paramatma lives in atma, so it indicates paramatma too. And when you are in higher consciousness, when you realize God, when you realize atma, when you realize paramatma, you will not be tempted by material gain at all. So you are not getting into delusion. So when you are not tempted by material gain, naturally you attain the state of, it is the next stage, attaining the stage of samadhi. That means equilibrium. You are not showing any, you remain with equanimity of intellect. That is a perfect yoga. So Krishna explains on intellect and how jnanis move to higher elevation, how they prepare themselves to moksha, then how they move away from material gains. In 54th sloka, Arjuna is now asking question. He has got doubts because he started receiving the upadesam from Krishna. So as he listens, he has doubts. So he is getting, he is asking questions as he is getting the doubts. So he has asked 16 questions, and these questions are distributed in different chapters, and Krishna answers for all this. This is what we are going to see in the remaining slokas. So the first question, which is pertaining to this topic, the second adhyayam, is what is the disposition of one who is situated in divine consciousness? This is the question asked by Arjuna to Lord Krishna. So in this sloka, Arjuna says, Keshava, one who killed Keshi, the demon. So you killed Deshi because he was very bad. So I have to. So here, by saying Keshava, we should, it is understood that Arjuna has to kill his ego. Arjuna has to kill his ignorance. So now he is asking, because when you ask questions only, you get it clarified and remove your doubts. This is how we kill the doubts. So here he is asking Krishna, Keshava, how does a jnani, that is one who attains the state of samadhi, or the same person is called Sitta Prajnan, how does he talk? How does he sit? How does he walk? Because they have got steady mind in God. They fix their mind in God and there is no deviation, no temptation. It is fixed. So Sthita Prajnan. Sthita Prajnan is the one who does not have wavering mind and his mind is fixed in God. And Sthita Prajnan and Samadhistha, they are all enlightened persons. So Arjuna is asking Krishna, how does he talk? How does he sit? How does he walk? And the answers given by Lord Krishna, through Jnanama, Jnana Marga, Karma Marga and Bhakti Marga, and he gave answers for meditation and austerity and clarified Arjuna's doubts. So the next sloka, Bhagavan says, he gives the answer to Arjuna for the question, what is the disposition of one who is situated in divine consciousness? So all these slokas help us to handle the situations in our daily life. So how to keep ourselves away from yearning more and more and more, and at one point of time we become greedy and we become unhappy and discontented. All this make our life miserable. So how to develop a good attitude, because the Lord Krishna says in this adhyayam, so the adhyayam is divided into four. The first one, Arjuna was wrong in his logical and reasoning power. And second, Krishna corrects them. Third, Krishna gives practical guidance to him. And fourth one, Krishna explains the attributes of people who follow all these teachings. So all these teachings help us to lead a very peaceful, contented life for us. Nammalvar explains how to remain from material world and how to reach moksha through one of his pasurams from Thiruvalmuli. Kannan kalal inai nannum manamudaiyir ennum thirunamam thinnam naraname. Nammalvar says, hold the golden feet of Lord Narayana and keep chanting his nama. You are protected by him. You are taken to moksha. So, to get that stage, we have to follow the teachings given by Lord Krishna. So, Nammalvar says, we have been given all the teachings by Lord Krishna, and let us hold his golden feet and keep chanting his nama, then we can attain moksha. So Nammalvar is considered as the head of Jnanis. Lord Ranganatha himself called Alvar as Nammalvar. And in the teachings of Lord Krishna, we find how he takes us to different elevations. So he is taking us step by step. The first step, Atmajnanam, Karma Yogam. The next, Jnana Yoga. At Jnana Yogam, we find nothing disturbs us. We concentrate only on Atma. Then, Atma Satchakaram. So there you find you got a very peaceful mind. There is clarity in our mind. So we don't do any more bad karmas, because there is no more motivation from us. So we don't do any more bad karmas. So he is taking us beautifully and in a very practical way. So there's a possibility for every man to become Stitha Prajnan. So Nammalvar is Stitha Prajnan. He never allowed his mind to get exposed to worldly things. So let's follow his pasurams and Bhagavad Gita to lead our life peacefully in our daily life.